At 0750 hours this morning, there was a call for service in reference to a shooting at Carver High School, 2201 West Presstman Street. At 0752 hours, our first officer was on the scene. At 054 hours, an officer had already applied a chest press as well as a tourniquet to one of the victims. As of right now of this reporting, there are two juvenile victims, 16 years old, that attended Carver High School. There was a third walk-in victim, also a juvenile at 17 years of age. All three victims are in non-life-threatening condition at University Hospital. This is an active crime scene. It's still early in the investigation as of right now. Crime Lab is on the scene. As you well know, instantly, school police and their protocols put the school on lockdown, which they are currently still in at the moment. In reference to the individual suspect, we do know the individual is a unidentified African-American male who did flee eastbound on Presstman Street. We are actively working right now doing concentric searches in reference to identifying this individual with the use of not only CCTV cameras, but school cameras in the area.
Do we know how it all happened?
Still active investigation. We do know that there was a possible fray, and then there was a discharge of a weapon.
We had heard from a parent that the kids had known for days something was going to happen. Have you heard anything about that?
Early in the investigation, I cannot confirm or deny.
Is the alleged shooter a student here?
It is still early in the investigation. We are unaware.
Next, anyone else?
What kind of weapon was used?
Still early in the investigation. We do know we have multiple casings on the ground.
So multiple weapons?
We have multiple casings on the ground.
Can we hear from school officials as to why kids are still being allowed into school and why this whole area isn't blocked off to be made safe for students?
Well, students that came in anytime around there, went into their normal entrances and went on lockdown immediately, right? And if kids made their way in, we wanted to make sure they are safe. And so we got them into a safe place and have kept them there. And we should be very clear. The families of the victims have already been communicated with. So if there are families of Carver students, right, they should know that their child is here and fine and safe and is not one of the victims, because we've already communicated with those families.
I will say that in reference to my specific response here, I came from North Avenue and I did have to go through several layers of block streets that school police had cordoned off.
Walk us through, school was about to start. Walk us through buses arriving. How did this all unfold right over here? Just from the early indication of this investigation, how did this begin?
As I said before, there was some kind of a fray. I don't know about buses. It's still early in the investigation. It would be irresponsible for me to speak of that right now.
Anyone who hasn't asked a question yet?
When you say chest press and tourniquets, was it just one victim, multiple victims?
So the one victim had a shot to his left chest as well as his hip. The second victim that was on the scene in the courtyard had a graze wound to his hip. I am unsure of where the gunshot wound was for the third walk-in victim. The victim that did have the gunshot wound to his chest had a chest seal put on as well as a tourniquet.
Anyone else?